Lastly, let's talk a bit about interfaces and how using MongoDB, because that might be useful for your final year project, for instance. So MongoDB comes with a shell, which is quite useful. So you can run the Mongo command, and then you can directly manipulate this data storage. So you can always run the help function on an object. If you have an object X, you can run it. You can run a command like show collections, which prints all the living collections in the system. And with db.collection name, you can access the collection. And then you can add another dot to basically run one of these methods here, like submitting a find operation, inserting, updating, removing, dropping a collection, creating an index, sorting, and so on. Very interesting is also the explain operation, which describes what kind of operations will be performed. Here's one of the sessions. So I create a collection uni, and then I create actually a bulk operation. And in this bulk operation, I want to run certain operations. One is I want to insert this user here, this document here, and this document, and then I execute it. So I get two documents inserted, and I get a result which says two inserts have been done successfully. Next, I create an index on the name. Then I search for a document. I specify no query document, but I specify that I want the projections, I want the name field, and I want up to 10, so dot limit 10. So I get two documents now, I always get the ID, and now I get the names of those two documents, so which are the ones that we inserted. And we can also use more sophisticated find operations, like here with a query document where I search for a name should be Hans, which then is this document here. And I'm interested to get the birth field, which is then returned here as an output. So you can update documents here specifying a query again, and then the replacement, which is basically what is happening here. I specify the document with where the name is Julian. I want to set the address to something like this. And I can do multiple too, which means it will match all the documents where this query document matches. You can do also some aggregation here. So I want to count, for example, how for each gender, I want to group by gender and count and sum this up for everyone where the major is computer science. And finally, I will drop our collection. So that is a very basic example, but I hope you can see that you can already achieve a lot with MongoDB in terms of operation. In Python, we can do pretty much quite the same. So we just have to instance C8 Mongo client, and then we can perform the operations in a similar fashion. I'm not going here into detail.